In this video, we're going to look at how to design a pastor send-off invitation like this. And this is coming up. Hello everybody, it's Innocent here. If you're new to the channel, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much for showing up again. So here are the few resources that I'll be using in this video. If you want to download and follow suit, the link is in the description. You are welcome. So let's jump right into Photoshop. Now the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to create a new document. So Control plus N to create a new document. And since this is going to be the invitation type, you can go for anything like the DL. So I go for the size DL over here because I want it to be very simple and small. Okay, so I'll go ahead and click OK. The next thing that I will do is I go to image rotation, and I'm going to rotate this 90 clockwise so that I can have it in a landscape form. Moving on, let's start with the background. First things first, I'm going to create a new rectangle. So I'll pick my rectangle tool and I'm going to draw a rectangle up to about this point. We are going to try to adjust this as we move on. So I'm going to try to use the actual colors when I bring in the logos, but for now let's set any yellow color for it. So you double click on the layer thumbnail here and you're going to set a yellow color, let's say this one, and I'll go ahead and click OK. The next thing that we're going to do is going to press Ctrl J to make a duplicate. Now this one is on top of the yellow one, that is where we actually want it. So what we're going to do is going to right click, go to the blending options, and we can add a gradient overlay. So we go to the gradient pack here, have a couple of them. So I'm going to drag down to the bottom and I'm going to use this particular gradient. So these are the hex codes in case you want to use them. This is the first one and this is the second one. So you go ahead and then you can use these colors. So let's go ahead and click OK, and we maintain this at linear. Let's change this one to about 81, let's say, and let's reverse it. Something like this is okay for me. And then I'll go ahead and I'll click OK. The next thing that we'll do is we're going to drag this beneath of the yellow rectangle and we can have it around here. But like I said, we're going to have to be making some changes very soon. So the next thing, we're going to draw some circles around this area. So let's create a new layer so that it doesn't mess up with the rectangle, and we're going to select the ellipse tool. With the ellipse selected, we're going to create a new ellipse. So you hold shift to create a perfect circle and then you can push it to the very corner of this one. We're trying to create a shape so that this wouldn't look very plain, just plain. Okay, so you can drag this one here somewhere like that. And to make sure that the both ends are on the same or equal parts, we go to view, new guideline, and we're going to set a guideline about 15% like that. Okay, right there. So we can shift this one to be right here and push it up a little bit like that. So we have to do the same thing for the other end. So we're going to create a new guideline again, and 15 from that will be 85, so 85%, so that both ends will be the same. Now we're going to drag the effect on the rectangle, this one, onto the ellipse that we just created. So I'm going to hold Alt and click on the effect and drag it right onto the ellipse that we created. Sounds cool, right? So we're going to duplicate this one again. Press Ctrl J to duplicate, and then you can bring this one over here. Just that, you're going to press Ctrl T to transform that one out, and you can position it over here. So the next thing that I will do is I'll right click on this one and I'm going to clear layer style so that everything that we have on the second ellipse will be off. Now what we're going to do is we're going to double click on that one, pick a color from here, and then we can send it underneath of the first color. So somewhere around here, and you can position it right like that. Press Ctrl T, transform it, just make sure that it blends over there. So I can click on the layer thumbnail again and pick even a much closer color like that, and that is the shape that I'm looking for. Click OK, hold Ctrl, select the second ellipse, and then you can press Ctrl G to group it. You press Ctrl J to duplicate it, and you can press Ctrl T to transform. That's a lot of pressing to do. So you flip it horizontally and then you can send it to the other side of our document. And you see the reason why we had to set that particular grid lines, just to guide us get this in shape. Now we are all done with the background. The next things that we're going to input here is the text. Okay, so let's pick the text tool. The first font that I'm going to use is called Alex Brush. I'll leave links in the description in case you want to download it. So I'm going into the text that I've already written and I'm going to copy that and I'll paste it right over here. So I'll press Ctrl T to transform it and I can open it up like that. Press Ctrl A, position it in the middle. That is, you align it horizontal centers and there you have it. You can take your time to scale this one. So something like that and you're good to go. So special invitation, let's make it a bit smaller like that. Okay, we press Ctrl J to duplicate the text and we bring it right beneath of it. We edit that to Poppins. That is the next font that I'm going to use. Links in the description. So I'll go into my text again and I'm going to copy the whole of these ones. I've already made the arrangement, so it is going to be centered and we're going to paste it right over here. So the next thing you do is you press Ctrl T, transform it to be a bit smaller like that. You press Ctrl A, make sure it is aligned horizontally, and then you can select the whole of this one, change it to something like semi bold. Don't make it so bold, something like that we do, and then we have it over here. So as you go on, you try to position your text to look very nice and very clean. Again, we're going to duplicate the special imitation here, bring it down like that, and we're going to select all of that. Once again, we go into our text and I'm going to add this very long text. Please advise your pastors not to submit long tests like this. So I'm going to press Ctrl V to paste it, change the font to Acrobat, and that is my third font for today, which links will be in the description. So I'll press Ctrl T right over here and I'm going to try to close it up to make it very very small like that, because we can't have this very long text and make it bold and bigger like that. So let's select it all, go to the font type, and we're going to change this one to semi bold, right? Let's change the color as well to dark blue, very dark blue, and let's select a couple of them here from the specially invite. We're going to change that font to Brush Script. I promise to use fewer fonts. So let's just make sure that this is in the middle. So you press Ctrl A and then you center it. The next thing that we do is we go for our rectangle tool again and going to create a rectangle. So the rectangle will be here. You create a very small one like that. Change the color to black or dark blue so that it can be seen, something like that. And you press Ctrl A to center it. So that's what we're going to use, or write the person that we're inviting's name on there, right? So you can take your time to position it. Something like this we do. Next off, another duplicate. So we're going to make a duplicate again, and this time it is this one, this circuit superintendent, and we drag it down here. So we go for our test tool, select this one, select it all, and then we go into the test again. We have this particular test right over there and we press Ctrl C to copy it and we'll paste it in Photoshop. So Ctrl V. Now this is where, or the person that we are inviting, whether the person can be a guest of honor, any invitee that you are actually inviting. Is that even an English word? So you press Ctrl A, make sure that this is centered by aligning it horizontally. You can see from the top that everything is in alignment, that is centered, everything is centered, and that makes your design quite okay. Now we want to add the main theme, that is the send-off and Thanksgiving, but we are actually going to add a picture here as well. So why don't we bring in the picture first to kind of determine whether the text will be up to this length or not. So let me go into my resources. I've got a picture of my pastor. It's not the best picture that I got, but sorry papa, if you are watching this, I would have to use it anyway. So I'm going to position them over here. That is the pastor and the wife, and we're going to transform it to make it a little bit smaller like that, so you can just tweak it a little bit smaller like that. The idea is to get them over here, but not to cover this text or this rectangle that we have. So you can press Ctrl T to kind of transform them a little bit to be bigger like that, because we want them seen. And now we can conclude that our text can be anywhere from this side. So we select the text tool and we're going to create a new text. Like I said, I'll be using the Methodist color, so I'm using the red for this one. And since we want it to be bold and kind of seen, we want to use the poppins and then the black here. So let's go into the text. We have the send off and Thanksgiving service. Copy that and you paste it right here. Now you press Ctrl T, transform it to make it a little bit bigger. So we can see that you can send it right to this side. And I think this looks quite very bold. So let's change this one to, instead of black, let's use the bold right over there. Now let's zoom in and see how we're working or how we're doing. Just like that, perfect. So you press Ctrl J, duplicate it, and you can drag it over here. So who is the send off in honor of? Let's go and find out. And it is in honor of the Reverend and Mrs. Yabans. So you copy that and you can paste it right over here by selecting all of this one. But we don't want to make it in red, so we can select our blue black back again. So you click OK. And then you can press Ctrl T to transform it out, something like that. So send off service, or send off and Thanksgiving service in honor of, let me add that, in honor of, so like this. And you can press Ctrl T to transform it out again. Now it's time to add the date, venue and time. So that is what we're going to put right here, and going to use a black color on top of the yellow so that it is going to blend out perfectly fine. But let me just fix this one. So you bring it down a little bit, make sure that your designs are always spaced out and we have a bit of air to breathe. Okay, so let's go into the text. What do we have here? I've already spaced out the text, as you can see right over here. So we need to select all of that. So select from Sunday to 10 a.m. copy that, and inside of Photoshop, you're going to use the same font. So you paste it right over here. And instead of bold, you're going to use semi-bold over there. So you can do that. And you can press Ctrl T, transform it to fit straight into the rectangle that you've created for it. Or if you want, you can just type them separate. That is one after the other. But that is going to take you like a lot of time. So you can just do it once like this. Now, the next thing that we have over here would have to be the date, location and time. That is the symbols. I just grouped all of them to save us all time. As you can see, the video is already long, so I'm going to position them right over here. Now I would have to make a little bit of adjustment because the spacing is not favoring me, so I'm going to right click on that, rasterize the layer. I'm going to use this rectangular marker to make a selection from here. And then I'm going to cut it from the main one so that I can push the location a bit here. And I can do the same thing for the time as well. So I can just push it up here like that. And if this feels so close, I can just open it up with the space bar. That is, open the text with a space bar. Now what that I have to do is push it like this and push my other layer like that. So you can bring in the symbols one after the other and do the test one after the other as well. With that said, we're going to add the last part of this video. So we go into our test. We have, that is the officiating ministers or the RSVPs. You're going to select all of them. I've not grouped this test, but I hope you get a concept. And I'm going to select the test right here and I'm going to paste it. And you're good to go. So the last thing that we add is for any other information or further information. And with that, you're going to use the rounded rectangle. Create a rounded rectangle underneath of the officiating ministers. Make sure that it is still white like this. The color is white. And then we can duplicate the text of the officiating ministers right from there. So we press Ctrl J, drag it on top of the rounded rectangle, and you can push it over here. So let's go into our last thing, that is my contact here, please. That is my contact. Okay, if you want to call me, hit that contact over there, and then you're going to select all of these ones. So you select it all and you paste what you copied. You're going to change that one to bold so that it can be very bold. Press Ctrl T to transform it out, but since it is white on white, you're not actually going to see it. So let's change the color to something dark blue that can be seen, so a color from this side so that it can blend. Okay, and then you click OK, and then you can drag this into for further information. So for any further information, don't hesitate to call me. The last thing that we bring in, which almost every design or every tutorial I kind of forget, is the logo. So let's go into our resources and bring the logo, and you can see that the logo has the colors yellow, blue, and then red, and that is the same colors that I've incorporated in making this particular invitation a success. So you can actually determine the colors to use for a particular design from your logos. And just like I said from the very beginning, you can actually change the color of this rectangle to match that of the logo, so something dark yellow instead of that plain yellow. So you can see the difference from here. This is the current color and this is what we pick, so you can see the difference and click OK. Maybe you can reduce your logo or any other thing that you practically want to add to this one will be out of your own creative imagination. And this one doesn't seem that very white, so let's give it, or let's make it white so that it can even stand out the more. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch this video. Please don't forget to check out other tutorials on church flyer, on banners, on business cards that I have on my channel. I'll see you guys in the next one. It's Innocent here, and bye.